Hey everyone, this is Jerry with San Pedro Mastery. I have made some videos on pollinating San Pedro flowers in the past, but my method have evolved, or should I say improved, as I've gained experience. Today, I am sharing with you some of my latest tips and techniques. This year, I'm very happy to report that my Peruvianus plants, which I got thanks to my buddy Suriel, have flowered for the first time. Here they are wearing pollination bags, waiting to be pollinated. But it would be cruel not to show you the flowers. So here they are without the bags. Absolutely gorgeous. I'm pretty sure I will be able to get some very neat crosses out of these. I just removed the bags long enough to shoot this video. Obviously, you don't want to leave them open for long, as an insect can come in. I always pollinate plants first thing in the morning. There are a lot less insects at that time. You may remember that in the past, the pollination bags I was using were either large glassine bags or woman's stockings. But this year, I found these bags, which are much better. These breathable bags are designed to store vegetables, and they are large enough to accommodate a fully open San Pedro flower. I bought two kinds of bags to try out. The one on the left is made of cotton. I found it in an organic food store. The one on the right is made of recycled plastic. I got this one in a large supermarket. They both have a cord that you can tighten around the base of the flower. The plastic bag hasn't got as fine a mesh as the cotton one, but I have not seen a single insect inside the flowers, not even tiny bugs, which means it is fine enough. The problem I have with these plastic bags is that the cord is very slippery and you need something to hold it tight around the base of the flower. The cord also often comes loose when you wash it, and it can be a pain to get it back where it should be. The cotton bag has a finer mesh, which is always better, and the cord is also made of cotton, which means it holds its position really well after you tighten it. This is why you should totally get the cotton bag. If you cannot get this particular make, I'm sure you can find something similar in an organic food store. If there is any downside to the cotton bag, is that it shrinks a little after you wash it, partly due to the fact it's now wrinkled. But that's not a problem. It's still large enough for a San Pedro flower. You may have noticed that I use plant markers to label the crosses. I bought these from Amazon. 300 tags in different colors. I'm very satisfied with them. I like the fact that you can adjust them. This will be useful when the flower wilts. You will need to tighten it more so that it doesn't fall down. Please be aware that often, the wilted flowers fall on the ground, and the marker together with it. If you find various markers on the ground, you probably won't remember which marker corresponds to which fruit. This is why I highly recommend that you make a video with your phone of all the tags while they are still on your plant. Like this, if some of the tags fall down, and some most likely will, you can remember which fruit it belongs to. Another thing I've changed from earlier videos is the way I collect the pollen. I now use a funnel, and the pollen ends up directly inside a test tube. You have to thoroughly wash and dry the funnel between plants. But of course, if you are collecting pollen from various flowers on the same plant, then you can reuse the funnel without washing it, since it will be the same exact pollen. When you remove the pollination bag, the anthers should be fat and fluffy, covered with pollen, as you can see them right now. To brush off the pollen from the anthers, I use my fingers, as the touch will be gentler. First, I move the stigma out of the way so that it doesn't get coated with pollen. Then you just want to gently brush the anthers with your fingers so that the pollen falls down onto the petals underneath. And then you gently brush the pollen that's on the petals towards the funnel. When you're done, the anthers will appear much smaller. It's because they are not coated in pollen anymore. Sometimes the pollen does not detach itself from the anthers. If that's the case, what often does the trick is to come back after a while, and then the pollen will come down. I'm not sure why that is, but my guess is that the pollen needs to be dry to become loose, and a few rays of early morning sun should help with that. Now, a special mention about hygiene. Hygiene is essential if you want to be sure your flowers are pollinated the way you want them to be. You need to wash your hands before and after every single step, such as collecting pollen or pollinating a flower. It's happened to me to wash my hands dozens of times in one morning, But that's okay, that's just a few days in a year, my hands can handle that. If you have many flowers to pollinate, be very methodical and concentrated in what you're doing, as it's very easy to make a mistake. Your phone should be in airplane mode, so that you don't get interrupted. Do one flower at a time, and label everything thoroughly. And if, like me, you have a lot of flowers, then you should decide beforehand, like for instance the day before, which flowers you're going to pollinate with what pollen. Write everything down. Here's a little summary of how I do it, step by step. For collecting the pollen, you first need to wash your hands. Then remove the pollination bags, which should have been placed on the flower before it opened. Collect the pollen. Replace the bag if you're not going to pollinate that flower right away. Close the test tube and label it. And by the way, these are 5 ml test tubes I got from Amazon. Pollinating a flower. Wash your hands. Place on a plate a small amount of pollen from a Trichocereus flower. Remove the pollination bag. To pollinate the flower, you need to gently swipe the stigma over the pollen until it has absorbed all of it. Be very gentle with the stigma. Place the plant marker on the flower. It's a good idea to prepare the markers beforehand. And finally, replace the pollination bag. Right after I've used all the pollen I need, I place the test tube with the leftover pollen in the freezer in a small container with a small bag of silica gel. Be careful, there are many fake silica gel bags for sale on the internet. Usually they are the cheapest ones. This is the make I use. From what I've been reading, it works. And the whole packaging comes sealed, which is very important for silica gel bags. Once the flowers are wilted, you can remove the bags, usually a day or two after the pollination. This is how the Peruvianus flowers look at the moment. For some reason, there are some species or strains that turn black when they wilt. Flowers from Pachanoi, for instance, don't do that. They don't turn black. In about 2 weeks, I will know if the pollination has worked or not. If the entire flower, including its base, falls on the floor, then it's game over. If on the other hand, a fruit forms, like you can see here on the right, it's very encouraging. Sometimes the fruit will fall, usually when it's very small. When it's that big, you can almost be sure that you will have seeds. By the way, you may be surprised that I already have a fully formed fruit. This year, there were a few early flowers from about a month ago. Just next to the fruit, you can see another flower bud. This one will open during a second big wave of flowers, probably in 4 to 6 weeks from now. I will have plenty more flowers during that second wave, and once again, I will be extremely busy and concentrated for a few days. Unlike last year, which for me was a terrible year for flowers, and therefore for fruits, this year my cacti are having tons of flowers, including on new plants I recently acquired, or plants that had not flowered before. This is great news, as it will allow me to produce many new seed varieties. Well, at least I hope, as a flower does not necessarily mean a fruit. In fact, I'm only hoping for about a third of the flowers to successfully turn into fruits, since a lot of the pollen I used is frozen, and some of it is old. When you have a lot of flowers, like this year, there are two possible strategies. You can only use fresh pollen, or you can also use frozen pollen in addition to the fresh one. If you only use fresh pollen, you're probably just going to have a couple of strains that flower on the same exact day. Each flower lasts a day, and the pollen has lost a lot of its viability the next day. So you're really looking to pollinate all the flowers on the same day. That means two things. First off, you only have a few seed varieties. Say you only have two Pachanoi that flower on the same day, which we'll call Pachanoi A and Pachanoi B. Well, with that, you can only produce two different varieties, A crossed with B and B crossed with A. But since you only use fresh pollen, and fresh pollen is more viable than the frozen one, your flowers will have more success turning into fruits. You will have a lot more fruits and therefore a lot more seeds. The other strategy is to use frozen pollen in addition to the fresh pollen. Of course, for that you will need some pollen stored in your freezer. With that strategy, you can end up with a lot more varieties, but there is a price to pay. Using all the pollen, you'll have less chances of the flower turning into a fruit. That means a lot less fruits and consequently a lot less seeds. So, more varieties, but a much lower total count of seeds. This second strategy is the one I've chosen. Because having more varieties is just more fun for me. And I'm also going to enjoy growing these seeds in smaller containers like I did in the past. So you can expect more small container videos in the future. I think that the seeds from this recent wave of flowers will be available around September. Or should I say, starting in September, since I will have them available for several months for sure. If you're interested in buying seeds, please send me an email saying that you would like to receive my list of seeds and I will email it to you with photos. You can find my email address in the description section of this video, but I will also make it appear on the screen now. When you email me, please mention your country. That's it for this video, my friend. I hope you enjoyed it. Please, please, please hit the like button. That's what it takes for the YouTube algorithm to rank my videos higher in the search results. I hope you guys and girls are having a wonderful summer in spite of the COVID restrictions, and I'll see you again very soon for another video. Ciao, ciao.